Kiss 104, Atlanta's R&B. That is the ultimate songwriter. I mean, it's wedding season.
Yeah. You know,
how many weddings have I been to?
Wow.
Folks have killed that song. But it is a beautiful love song.
Thank you so much.
You know what I mean? And it's refreshing. That's why I love Kiss 104, Atlanta's R&B, because we still play the beautiful love songs.
Yeah.
And love songs. You know, we can't talk about this song without talking about, and we talked a lot about it. You know, I'm going to tell you, in radio, you have the best conversations when you're ready.
When you're off the radio.
But I guess I can speak for the listeners as well. We all were very shocked and hurt because I felt you guys were the trophy couple. Mm. Kenny Lattimore and Shantae Moore. Mm-hmm. The last time I saw you guys together, you did a tribute to Otis Redding.
Oh, yeah.
Together,
oh,
yeah, here
God.
In Atlanta.
Yeah. That was fantastic.
Yes, and I was like, you know, sitting in the audience checking you guys out, like, oh, they're so intimate. So what happened, Kenny?
You know what? I think life happens, and I want to say this for the listeners. Now you may have more mature listeners.
Yes, we do.
but that doesn't make our choices mature necessarily, because it doesn't have to do anything with that. But when you're committing to marriage and being in relationships, I have a philosophy. You have to commit to the commitment of marriage more than you commit to just the person, because people let you down.
Now hold on for one second. You gotta say that again, because that is a very powerful statement that you just said.
People, when you get into marriage, you're committing to a commitment. Mm-hmm. Now, when you commit to a person's gonna let you down.
Yes, they will.
So you can't commit to someone on an emotional level, mm-hmm. because you're not gonna always feel like you're in love. You're not gonna always feel
have
like
that
you're supported.
Loving feeling.
Have that loving, oh gosh, that I'm just floating.
That new love feeling.
That new love feeling. Mm-hmm. But it's something that when you're married, you have to work at for a lifetime. That's why it exists for a lifetime. And we know that some people, you don't want to be in any abusive relationship. You don't want to be in a relationship where you're just completely, I'm just devastated, unhappy. This person does not love me, does not, those kind of, so it's mm-hmm. a balance to it all. Mm-hmm. But the reason why I put those particular things out there is because nothing in particular happened. You all know we're not in any scandal. There was no hitting and stuff going on. Right, nothing crazy going on, because we've never been that. But I think life happens. Mm-hmm. Life happens, and people make decisions based on what they believe will make them happy mm-hmm. as they move on in their lives. And I had to respect that. And we're not divorced.
Okay.
In spite of rumors and reports, but we are in the transition of it. And the reason why I say that is because in respecting the transition, for me to go, okay, I'm divorced, kind of opens me up to new relationships and new things mm-hmm. that may not be healthy mm-hmm. in this particular transition and can create a greater mess. Do I hope that things transition soon? I do, because I know that it would bring closure to a lot of things. Mm-hmm. And Shantae is a wonderful woman. She's an amazing singer. She's a great mother. And I wish her the best in everything that she does.
And it's a lot of folks, it's a lot of guys out there saying, dang, man, how you let Shantae go? Because she's beautiful. She's a beautiful woman. She really is.
But you know what? It's certain things that have to match completely. And a lot of things did match. Mm-hmm. So I don't want people to think that, oh, no, it was fake or something. It was almost 10 years, folks, that we were in this relationship. And we have a beautiful son.
And how is your son?
He is great. Mm-hmm. 9 years old.
Okay.
And, just enjoying the summer. She has him in camp and, mm-hmm. different kind of stuff.
And that's no problem? No, custody issues there?
No,
okay.
Not at all.
That's wonderful.
So from here, it's just a matter of I want her to be happy.
Okay.
And there are a lot of things that I learned, too. I'm not a perfect guy.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like my song. When my song says, I'm not too busy for you, it says, I am busy, but I'm not too busy.
So, was that your first marriage?
Yes,
okay.
My first marriage. And I was naive in a lot of areas. And,
mm-hmm.
and I think that I was idealistic mm-hmm. in a lot of areas. And we as men take on life and love differently than women. One thing I did learn, I'll tell you this, and I know you want to move on to other things, but one thing I learned, that one of the differences between men and women So fellas listening are interested in you.
This is Kenny Lattimore talking now.
Starting, building in the day. It could be something small. It could be writing on a little piece of paper that I love you, baby, and I can't wait to see you tonight.
Mm-hmm. And back that up with some action.
Yeah, and then let it go all the way through. But it was the simple things. Mm-hmm. It's the simple things that that carry through the day.
Yes.
And then it's that call during the middle of the day, and then it's making it happen in the evening. Whereas for a brother, it's a little different. It's like, oh, just take care of me in the evening, and we're cool. Or the way we experience love by respect. Mm-hmm. If you tell your man, I got your back no matter what, he's going to feel like he's loved. Mm-hmm. But if you tell a woman, baby, I respect you. I respect. She might be like, oh, that's nice.
That's wonderful.
Right, that's wonderful. But yeah. But not only show me, but still something about that love element. We receive love differently.
Yeah.
And we have to learn how people naturally give love and how they receive love, and balance those two as well, and accept one another for who we are. So it's a lot of elements to a lasting relationship. It really is. And a lot of us fall off track because sometimes we're just entering in and we're not looking at the right things. Sometimes our expectations are off. Mm-hmm. And you never want to put yourself in a position where your expectations are so high that you're putting the other person into a performance-based relationship.
Well, I have to say, you look unscathed. I don't know what's going on in the inside, but on the outside.
I'm happy because...
You don't look all scathed and jacked up.
I appreciate it.
You're going to be all right.
God has been good to me.
Yes, he is.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Yes, now.
And as a result, I mean, I'm here, and the music has kept me alive and in another place. I mean, alive in my spirit. You know, I think that I am fulfilling what my purpose is, what God intended for me to do on this earth. And that is the greatest thing ever, and that is to deliver this music. I want to speak to the minds of the men and the hearts of the women.
Now, I know music for you, like myself, makes me happy.
Yes.
So music is your happy place, I'm
absolutely
hoping. And you have a great new project that's out that's got a big old smile on your face, big old pretty white teeth, too. Tell
well,
us about
you.
your latest project. Back to Cool.
My latest project is Back to Cool, coming September the 18th.
Okay.
And I'm very proud of it. It is on my own record label, Sincere Soul Records.
Now, you have an original date of June, didn't you?
I did. I wanted it
now,
to come out
in
June.
Why y'all do that? Why y'all push stuff back?
You
why
know what happened?
What happened?
Because this is new for me. I'd say my man Rick Ross over here, he's my rep at Capitol.
Okay.
And because the project that I'm doing is with EMI Label Services and Capitol Records. But he'll tell you, I'm hiring and firing staff and trying to put it together, because this is the first time I've ever even thought about having a record label. It was never a dream of mine.
But more and more artists are doing that now.
And I think it's based out of necessity.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to.
Yeah.
And, and especially in this age with social media and things, you can
absolutely
do so much more for yourself than record companies sometimes are willing to do.
But the perfect situation is, I feel, for me at least, mm-hmm, is this situation, because I have the label services of EMI, which distribute the music and get it out
That's
there to the people.
Yep.
And then I have the marketing and promotion of Capitol Records, I mean the legendary Capitol Records,
mm-hmm,
to do those things that I know I don't have the staff to do.
Okay.
And I was... I'm in Atlanta. Yeah, I want to shout out to Demet Guidry,
okay,
Jay Wells, because they were the first people to make me think outside the box regarding having a label.
Mm-hmm.
And we had some talks some other places initially, but I think that they were covering a lot of those areas for me as well. And I don't think that was what God had for me.
Okay.
It was like, no, Kenny, I'm going to put this in your face.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to broker this deal. And you're going to have to understand how this thing works, so that when you go back and you work with your friends like Demet and Jay,
mm-hmm,
that they can help you out, but they're not carrying you through it. I would have laid myself right back and let them carry me, because I was used to that.
Right,
you know, I was really used to it. And they taught me a lot about how to structure and how to put things together, so that I was able to have a conversation, at least with EMI, with some knowledge.
So tell us about the final project. I mean, who are all the folks on
wow
your team? Some folks that we know, that, you know,
wow,
we may not, commonly know, but, you know.
Okay. Well, on the production end, for those of you that are into those liner notes, Carvin Higgins,
yeah,
Ivan Barayas, who did Music Soul Child, Jaheim,
mm-hmm,
Jill Scott, Vidal Davis, who also did Flowetry, and Marcia and Jill Scott. I mean, they, Sierra, everybody. and J.R. Hudson, who executive produced the latest Jill Scott album, I said, you know what, I want him to come in and do my album with me.
Okay.
So he executive produced with me, which was like being a Quincy Jones. He was listening to all of the songs together and helping me make it a cohesive project. So we brought in Layla Hathaway to do a duet. And the duet sounds,
Layla's
on the CD. And the song is very much like a Donnie Hathaway song.
Oh, that's sweet.
So it was great to have the richness of her voice and the history of her family and the family legacy, and to do a song that was reminiscent of her father. And Kelly Price put it down.
Woo!
Oh, she did some incredible work on here.
Yeah, man, she's on my fave five soul singing sisters. Get down.
Absolutely. You haven't seen her live do it, too.
Oh,
she's like,
gosh,
okay, just like it is on the record, she can bring it even stronger live.
She is Pentecostal or Church of God.
Yes.
Christ all rolled up in one.
All in one.
Smack that with some real soul bass.
Yes. Shanice did some stuff with me.
Shanice?
And, yep, she just made a little appearance. I appreciate her because she came in, my friend.
You're coming strong, man.
Oh, man.
You're coming strong.
It's been a phenomenal, phenomenal effort from all of those that contributed. I'm just so proud of the project.
This is a treat. This is a wonderful treat. Now, you have the single. It's called Find a Way.
Find a Way.
Tell
Find
us
a
about
way to
this,
win
and
her heart.
We're going to listen to this single and check it out.
All right. Find a Way to Win Her Heart. Find a Way to Win Her Love. Find a Way to Win Her Trust. That was another thing that I realized, is that a lot of times we as men don't know how to minister, how to serve the heart of a woman. It's something that, again, you learn through the years.
Yes, you do.
And it takes a tremendous amount of effort. It may not have happened in the first, you know, a lot of times you go through your love stage, it might last a couple years, and then you go through a lull where things are like, okay, I'm kind of figuring things out. I'm trying to figure out who I am again.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you can't leave her out. You got to make sure that you kind of come back. Winning her heart is a continual process.
You are so ministering to someone out there right now.
Oh,
you know, someone
God.
Needed to hear this today.
And I needed somebody to minister that to me.
All right.
When
you
I was
know
no.
What I mean? Sometimes, you know what I mean? All
but
things work together for the good.
That's
you
right.
You know what I mean?
And that's right. So,
yeah.
And I believe that because of my experiences, even going through the transition that I'm going through, it gives me an authentic place to actually talk about this positively.
And it's amazing how God uses us, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Kenny Lattimore is in the studio. Kiss 104, Atlanta's R&B. Cynthia Youing. It's just a nice little chat and chew. We just chat and chew it.
Yeah.
We're going to listen to the single. It's called Find a Way. Kenny Lattimore from Back to Cool.
Yeah.
Back to Cool.
Coming
really soon. So let's check this out. Atlanta's R&B. Kiss 104.